I think this has been a very valuable discussion today. I thank you all for participating in it. I think a few final points. It goes without saying, after listening to David's talk and reflecting on the gravity of the consequences, that all of us here are fully committed and will do what we can in the time ahead to prevent this from ever happening. I think some of us have jobs where we have more leverage in that realm than others, but it's obviously the most important thing. But beyond that, in addition to that, we also have to put some amount of our effort in thinking about what we would do if this ever happens in the United States. I think we heard today the United States has made, the government and elements of the private sector and NGOs have made strides in answering technical questions and providing technical information, initiating programs, but I think we all agree there is a tremendous amount of work to do to put these things into place. For example, if there are ways to save tens of thousands of lives of those who've had radiation illness, and there's a way we could have done that feasibly, then there will be a compounded national tragedy beyond the nuclear event. So it's incumbent on us to understand what we could do to save thousands of lives and to do what we can in non-extraordinary ways to try and make progress. We also heard about specific actions that could help us recover and help people relocate and establish basic needs. We all clearly heard that to get this done, we need the public to understand more than it does now. And again, if we know what the public needs to do, but we haven't told the public what they needed to do, then we will have a second national tragedy on top of the first. So I think the good news, if there is any good news in this discussion, is that I think there's been a strong case made today that we could conceivably save thousands, tens of thousands, potentially hundreds of thousands of lives by particular specific things in the aftermath of a nuclear detonation. So with that as a glimmer of hope in this dark topic, let me thank all of the speakers who worked hard today to make a very compelling presentation and present their information to you in, I think, very useful and clear ways. Let me thank the Sloan Foundation for their support of this effort, and thank all of my colleagues at the Center for Biosecurity for all the hard work in making this a very valuable event, and all of you for your work on these issues and for your organization's dedication to these issues. I think we would not be where we are unless all of you, particularly the people who are working in the government on these matters and the NGOs dedicated to these matters, weren't doing this day in, day out. So with that, let me invite you to the reception upstairs for those of you who can stay, and we can continue this conversation. And other than that, the meeting is adjourned. Thanks so much. Thank you.